All right, this is a very short video. All right, well, the plan is to have a kind of a short video of some hardtop restoration that I'm doing. I've asked a couple people, ChefTush and Elwood, to take a look at this for me and just sort of look over my shoulder and tell me what they think. This is the school car hardtop that's been repainted. It was white, and it's now a Cayman blue mica paint, and super smooth. They did a great job. Got a run here. It's another time, another story. But this is my hard top with no glass in it. And before I get going, I wanted to show at least those two gentlemen, anybody else might be interested, the fuzzy that goes around the front of the car that comes in three pieces for a TR6. The front piece has none of this stuff on it, none of this weather stripping on it. And then the side pieces come down and are cut and come down at a 90 degree angle. I bought one of these taupe from the roaster factories for GT6 in just full length. And I'm gonna modify it down. I've already practiced cutting the body or the weather stripping off, and it works great. So in other words, you don't have to have three pieces. You can buy this stuff to length. I don't remember how much I bought, but it was, you know, whatever the math was, add an extra foot or whatever for whatever, but it's it matches the paint I'm going to use. So I'm, I forgot to say, I'm spray painting my fabric, this stuff here, and in the hardtop up in here, right? The material is in good shape. This is a outdoor fabric by Rustoleum. It's taupe. Literally, I just happened to stumble on it at Target. $12. It wasn't a cheap bottle, but anyway, it's almost literally exactly that. So I'm gonna have the trim and the hood liner itself painted with this. You can see some of that fuzzy still on the car, still on the sides over there. See that? The stuff right here, which kind of peels off. So that's gonna be replaced by this stuff here, all the way around the car. So anyway, the purpose of this today was to take a look at some of the quality, not only of the paint or the fabric, but what's happened to my insulations. This was 2000 or 1999 when I had my hood liner replaced by a shop north of Dallas, and at the time I think they did a really good job. I just think recently it started to pull away, but you can see where I need to really get in there and clean. We'll take some suggestions on what to clean it with, and I need to probably, well, when I shoot the spray, it'll probably cover that. But I think for the most part, the hood liner is in good shape. No tears, seats beat, you know, I've taken pretty good care of it, but just wanted to get some video so everybody can see sort of the condition of the material itself. You can see some wrinkles, right? And I'm wondering if the heat gun will take some of these wrinkles out. And I'm prepared to sort of go in there and poke with pins and pull this back, maybe soften that, wet it or whatever, and just iron it out. Maybe an iron will work. I've got sort of a hobby iron that would work great on that. Still some darkness up in there, and just some more, just general cleanup that I got to do. So on the hood liner and the material itself, I just want to make sure I've got a good cleaning material to do that. And do me a favor, Chef, if you get this, ask, or if either one of you know this, the rubber that I'm going to put back on here, I've got plenty of space here, but when my thumb gets down in the corner down here, my finger has very little space to go to. Like, the outside's fine, it's just the inside. You can see my finger stops right there, and I think on both sides. So I'm assuming the rubber will just mold around that. The other part of this was my condition. The underside of where the bottom side of my hardtop fits the car, and my hardtop is scarred up. My old paint job, I don't want to do that again. So I never touched it. I never looked at the condition. I never really, you know, looked at the rubber quality. And right now I'm thinking I just need to probably just replace all that. But what I'm really worried about also is just the condition of all the stuff that's in here. And this looks like glue. There's, I think, some surface rust in there. Let's see. I mean, it's scratched on it or whatever, but I'm gonna
put a wire brush on it and see what happens, but I think it's
probably rust, or it could just be glue. It's really kind of hard to say. These little rubber pieces are still in place. My whatever thing is, it's right here, and I'd taken it off just to take a look at it. But anyway, I just want to get a sort of a walk around of all the condition of the body, the bottom side, with this new paint job. I don't want to damage my new paint, right? And I'll say this, to even clean this thing, I don't want to lay it upside down on its paint to clean it. Like, I'm already thinking about how to suspend it with some rope or something in the garage, so that I can just sort of work on it there. Because it's a brand new paint job. I'm getting a little weird about it, but that was it. In condition of the hood liner and the little corners where they've kind of pulled away, and then the underside. The paint, for the most part's fine. They're going to fix this run, obviously, but once I get all that sorted, just painted with this stuff, I'll put my snaps back on. I've been fiddling with some practice snaps. Well, this is not what I'm going to finish with, but I'll have all that back in place too. So, anyway, thank you.